Good afternoon. Today I'm going to be refuting the claim that the Common Core system is an inefficient method of educating students in grades kindergarten through high school. The claims supporting the statement were that the system requires extra training for teachers and instructors, the system requires access to expensive technology, and the state standards are not the solution to a better education. But today I'm going to argue that the Common Core educational system is a more efficient way of educating students in grades kindergarten through high school. Contrary to my opponent's first claim in the new system, the first claim that the new system requires extra training for teachers and instructors, due to the new and improved Common Core standard system, students and educational staff will be using teaching methods that improve students' understanding and thinking skills, leading them to a greater understanding of what they are being taught. The evidence that was given to support the first claim were both statements given by teachers across the country about how teachers are going to be taught Common Core, not statistical data or evidence about supporting the claim that extra training is going to be needed and how it will affect the United States educational budget. The teacher training that will be implemented for Common Core will only increase teachers' knowledge about the subjects they teach, as well as learning more efficient ways of teaching material. According to the Common Core standards, workshops will be provided to both teachers and educational staff in order to better their knowledge of both the subject they teach and their teaching methods. The speaker's next claim was that the new Common Core system requires access to expensive technology. Contrary to that belief, due to the increase in technology in our world today, it is vital that students are taught how to use this technology and how to integrate it into the way that they learn. The expensive technology that is required for Common Core testing just consists of access to either a computer or a tablet. The technology that is needed would really not be too expensive and would better educate students. Schools already have access to technological devices that are needed for Common Core testing methods. According to the National Center for Educational Statistics, 97% of classrooms across the United States have access to a computer, making the goal of testing on a technological device completely feasible for the Common Core implementation. The third claim that my opponent made was that state standards are not the solution to a better educational system. But according to my evidence, Common Core state standards will bring the United States up to the educational level of other countries, as well as adopting higher standards for states that may be lacking in the educational department. According to Common Core, the state standards initiative, setting state standards does not mean that the testing standards will be lowered in order to accommodate all schools, but raising the standard in order to improve the educational system as a whole. Raising the state testing standards in order to bring the United States educational level up to the same standard as the rest of the world can only be beneficial to students in the educational school system. In conclusion, the Common Core educational system will be both beneficial for students and teachers in grades kindergarten through high school. Thank you.
Structurally, everything's easy to follow. On the issue, on the first point about whether or not Common Core is more efficient, there's a discussion of training, and it's a little bit circular here. There's a presupposition that training automatically increases a teacher's ability to know something about the subject, but there's not really any demonstration of that. And in fact, it seemed to me that the advocate suggested that the training was often frustrating, confusing, and prevented the instructors from knowing how to teach their students any differently than they are currently doing so. All you cite is that the standards are that there are workshops to better knowledge. Okay, so where has Common Core standard worked? Have we seen a demonstration that the teachers' knowledge of their subject has improved? I just get the standards on these points rather than any proof that the standards are working. So you've got the claim about what it's supposed to do, but that's what the argument's about. Just repeating what it's supposed to do doesn't demonstrate that it does those things. And you have the same kind of issue on the third point too, where you were basically saying, well, the goal here is to bring us up to the standards of the rest of the world or the standards of all the various states. Well, I know that that's the goal. Where's the proof that it's doing that sort of thing? The advocate says that it's not going to accomplish that, and you say, well, that's the goal of what it's supposed to do, and I'm still sitting here wondering, well, where's the demonstration that it's making a difference? Even at a pilot level, we should be able to see some places where that have used Common Core that they've had some kind of improvement. On the access to technology point in the middle, you know, everybody acknowledges that technology is going to be important. The problem is that is it as available as everybody thinks it needs to be in order for this program to work? I thought you started off with the right idea here, that all the schools have access to computers. Most of the classrooms do. I think that that works pretty well. And then you say, you know, basically it's the cost of a tablet or a computer. Well, it's a little bit more than that. And by the way, if you're talking about the cost of a tablet or computer and you're doing that for each individual student, that's pretty damn expensive. So that may be one of the reasons that people are a little bit critical of this. And once again, why is taking the test on, doing the tests online or going through the exercises online more productive? This should be something that is easily demonstrated, because the Common Core folks, when they advocated these policies, had to demonstrate that those programs would be effective. Otherwise, they wouldn't have adopted these particular standards. So I just think that there's some information missing here, that you've got the kind of the right arguments to be making, but you've got the wrong evidence to be supporting them. What you've got is evidence about explaining what the goal is instead of evidence showing us that we are achieving that goal with the tools that Common Core uses. All right.